Hello, this is Dr. Glasbrenner from George Mason University, and in this video, we will learn about the principles of tidy data and how it relates to organizing and reshaping data. The tidy data concept was formulated and articulated by Hadley Wickham, the core developer of the tidyverse packages and one of the authors of the R for Data Science textbook. Tidy data refers to a standardized format for organizing data that, when followed, allows the tools of the tidyverse to work as intended. There are three principles that need to be followed in order for a dataset to be considered tidy. Those principles are: 1. Each variable must have its own column, which is represented by the leftmost figure. 2. Each observation must have its own row, which is represented by the middle figure. And 3. Each value must have its own cell, which is represented by the rightmost figure. So why should we care about organizing our datasets according to the principles of tidy data? According to R for Data Science, tidy data is worth considering because, 1. There's a general advantage to picking one consistent way of storing data. If you have a consistent data structure, it's easier to learn the tools that work with it because they have an underlying uniformity. And 2. There's a specific advantage to placing variables in columns because it allows R's vectorized nature to shine. As you learn and mutate in summary functions, most built-in R functions work with vectors of values. That makes transforming tidy data feel particularly natural. In fact, you might not have realized it, but all of the datasets you've encountered so far in this class have been organized according to the tidy data principles, which has allowed us to apply functions from the dplyr and ggplot2 libraries in a straightforward way. So, translating all this, we arrive at the core takeaway. Getting data into this form allows you to work on entire columns at a time using short and memorable commands. It also allows us to avoid using loops as we work with our data. If you've programmed before, you are probably familiar with loops. In other languages, data manipulation may require you to tell your computer to scan the tabular dataset one cell at a time. R can do this, but it's slow. For this reason, the vectorized tools of the tidyverse are both faster and easier to understand. There are also theoretical reasons to prefer this format. The principles of tidy data are closely related to the formalism of relational databases. If you follow these rules, then your data will be in CODD's third normal form. Having your data in this format and getting into the habit of organizing it this way is helpful if you are working with a large or complex enough dataset that you need to store in a formal database, such as SQL databases like Postgres SQL and MySQL. So, practically speaking, the tidying process makes the categories in your data more clear. It makes analysis much easier too, because you can easily subdivide your data by category and apply transformations where needed. Thus, the tidy data format provides a standardized, best practices way to structure and store our datasets. Of course, it is important to note that just because this is a good format for analysis doesn't mean it is convenient in all scenarios. For example, you may not collect or input your data straight into a tidy format. The point is that you should reshape it into the tidy data format before you begin your data analysis. It is important to note that, as we use these terms in this class, data tidying and data cleaning do not refer to the same thing. Data tidying does not encompass the entire data cleaning process. Instead, it only refers to reshaping the dataset, such as moving columns and rows around. During the tidying process, a dataset's content will not change. All that changes is the way it's laid out in a table. Data cleaning, on the other hand, encompasses other tasks, including extracting data from an unstructured source, correcting spelling errors, renaming variables, imputing missing data, validation, and the list goes on. The tidier package, also part of the tidyverse, contains functions that allow you to reshape datasets to be in accord with the tidy data principles. The functions in tidier are oriented towards the kinds of datasets we've worked with previously, where each column may be a different data type, numeric, string, logical, etc. The functions are used in a way that will feel very similar to the dplyr verbs, for example, filter and mutate, that we learned in the previous module. There are four main verbs that we will learn about from the tidier package over the course of the next four videos: gather, which transforms wide data to narrow data; spread, which transforms narrow data to wide data, separate, which makes multiple columns out of a single column, and unite, which makes a single column out of multiple columns.